Let us study about equipotential surfaces. As the name implies, about equipotential surfaces, we can write a surface on which at every point potential is same is called an equipotential surface. To understand equipotential surface in an electric field, let's first consider a uniform electric field in which electric lines of forces are parallel and equidistant from each other. This is the direction of electric field. And say we consider a point A in the field. And say we place a charge Q at point A. And in a direction perpendicular to electric field, we displace the charge to a point B. If the charge Q is displaced from point A to B in the direction perpendicular to electric field, you can see the displacement and the force on the charge are perpendicular to each other. So in this situation, we can say work done in displacing the charge from A to B is zero. And we know that the work done in displacing a charge is written as charge multiplied by potential difference Vb minus Va. And if this is equal to zero, this implies here Va is equals to Vb. That means point A and B are at same potential. Or we can say we consider an imaginary surface in the direction in such an orientation that at every point it is perpendicular to electric field. At every point of the surface, the electric field is normal to it. Then in this situation we can say all the points of this surface will be at same potential because in the similar logic, with the similar logic we can prove it. So, here in this situation we can say if the surface is S, then we write all points on surface S will have same potential. And hence this surface we can call as equipotential surface. And in the similar manner we can define that in an electric field, if we consider any surface which is perpendicular to electric field at every point, can be regarded as an equipotential surface. Like we can write down a note to understand equipotential surface also that in an electric field, a surface of which at every point direction of electric field is normal to the surface is an equipotential surface. So this is the way how we define an equipotential surface in electric field, and it's vice versa is also true. Like if there is an equipotential surface, then at every point of equipotential surface, electric field will also exist in the direction normal to it. Now, in continuation, let's discuss the equipotential surfaces in different field configurations. So here, dear students, let's discuss a situation that if there exists just a point charge, and we know that in the surrounding of point charge, the electric field exists in radially outward direction. Like you can see, these are the electric lines of forces away from the positive charge. And if we just consider a surface at every point of which electric field is normal, you can see there are concentric spheres we can imagine in this situation, like you can see here. So, these are, you can say, spherical equipotential surfaces which exist in the surrounding of a point charge. Like we have discussed that equipotential surfaces are those which are perpendicular to the electric field at every point on the surface. Similarly, here you can see this is a very long infinite uniformly charged thread, and the surrounding of this thread, we know that electric field exists in radially outward direction. And if we consider some surfaces and its surrounding at every point of which this electric field is perpendicular, then you can see the surfaces are cylindrical in nature. These are coaxial cylinders. So we can say here cylindrical equipotential surfaces exist in the surrounding of a uniformly charged long thread. In the similar manner, whenever you are given with some electric field configuration, you can imagine different kind of equipotential surfaces, but always keep in mind that at every point of equipotential surface, electric field exists in the direction normal to the surface at every point.